Beautiful. So we're gonna get into you guys. This is Eminem Beautiful. Let's get it.
On the block, pull up, skirt, skirt. Where you at?
Where you at?
You a kid, bitch, I sit you on my lap tonight. Talking tough, we was never into that. I'm on the block, pull up, skirt, skirt. Where you at? Ass fat, they like, damn, what is that?
What it at?
Black cars pushing pieces to the mat.
This is Eminem's fans basically wanting Eminem to basically come back into the spotlight. So, do you hear me calling?
Are you reaching out for me? I'm reaching out for you.
I'm just so fucking depressed, I just can't seem to get out this slump. If I could just get over this hump, but I need something to pull me out this dump. I took my bruises, took my lumps, fell down and I got right back up.
Okay, so right here, Eminem's talking about his addiction and how he feels he cannot get over it. Depression can be so meaningful, like, depression just takes your energy drive, away. This is where you want to just be closed in, away from people, away from society. But in real life, you want to be around people, but you don't. Your inside is just like, no, I can't. I'm depressed. I'm sad. It's like the dark side. But instead of isolating yourself, you have to come over that. You have to overcome that, you guys, to force yourself to interact with people, to get out in the world, to not hide. So in a Not Afraid, M learned that it was hard work and dedication of his craft that would eventually pull him out of the dumps and slumps.
But I need that spark to get psyched back up in order for me to pick the mic back up. I don't know how or why or when I ended up in this position I'm in. I'm starting to feel distant again, so I decided just to pick this pen up and try to make an attempt to vent, but I just can't admit or come to grips with the fact that I may be done with rap. I need a new outlet.
I need a new outlet. You never know when the pressure's gonna come. It just hits you. It just hits you and it hits you hard. And it's just like, where the fuck did I go? Where did this come from? Some days I struggle depression. Like, it's not every day, obviously, because some days I have good days. But most days it's sadness. I don't know why, but it's just some things you just have to deal with, and it's just a real battle out here. It is a real battle, and just something you have to overcome, and something you have to occupy your mind to get you off that depression mode, to get you out of bed, to get you entertained, to get you more excited about life. And that's one reason why I started YouTube, you guys, because I have no friends. I don't have nobody to communicate with. You guys are who I communicate with, besides my kids and their father. But you guys are basically my friends and family. Like, I have none in this real world. So yeah, you guys. Well, friend-wise, I have family, but I don't hang with nobody, literally, at all. So, yeah, depression is serious, you guys. You have to find something to occupy your time. But most of all, don't let the battle win. Don't let depression win.
And I know some shit's so hard to swallow, but I just can't sit back and wallow when my own sorrow. But I know one fact, I'll be one tough fact to follow. One tough fact to follow. I'll be one tough fact to follow.
Yeah.
Here today, going tomorrow, but you have to walk 1,000 miles.
Is known as a good rapper. And whether people like him or not, it's tough to find someone who has accomplished the thing he has done. He feels like everyone who is better than him is dead or retired. So once he's gone, no one else can match style. If you believe you have what takes to outdo M, you have to work real hard for it. But I know one fact, I'll be one tough act to follow, one tough act to follow.
My shoes just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, my straight shoes just to see what it be like to. Your pain, you feel mine, go inside each other's minds just to see what we find.
Go inside each other's minds.
Each other's eyes.
But don't let you go say line.
You. Everything's so tense and gloom. I almost feel like I gotta check the temperature.
Now I'm taking
room, just as soon as I walk in, it's like all eyes on me. So I try to avoid any eye contact, cause if I do that, then it opens the door for conversation. Like, I want that. I'm not looking for extra attention, I just wanna be just like you. Blend in with the rest of the room. Maybe just point me to the closest restroom.
I just wanna be like you. I don't want shots, cameras. I don't want cameras taken every day. I don't want to sign autographs. Maybe some days, but not every day. Not every day I'm out and open. I don't want that. I'm still a human. I'm just, I'm just like you.
I don't need no fucking manservant trying to follow me around and wipe my ass. Laugh at every single joke I crack, and half of them ain't even funny like that. Marshall, you're so funny, man. You should be a comedian, goddamn. Unfortunately, I am. I just hide behind the tears of a clown. So why don't you all sit down? Listen to the tale I'm about to tell. Hell, we don't gotta trade our shoes, and you ain't gotta walk no thousand miles. My shoes just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, let's trade shoes just to see what it'd be like to feel your pain, you feel mine. Go inside each other's minds just to see what we find. Look at shit through each other's eyes. But don't let him say you. Take these cards ourselves and flip them. Don't expect no help.
No, we didn't ask for this life. It's just the life our parents gave us. But it's up to you to make it better. You don't have to live in a situation you are in. You have to do better. Just because you come from a dark place or a sad place doesn't mean you cannot go to a happy place. Doesn't mean you cannot go further than your parents or whoever raised you or wherever you're raised from. Like, doesn't mean you cannot do better.
Now I could have either just sat on my ass and pissed and moaned, or take the situation in which I'm placed in and get up and kick my own. I was never the type of kid to wait by the door and pack his bags, or sat on the porch and hoped and prayed for a dad that showed who never did. I just wanted to fit in every single place, every school I went. I dreamed of being that cool kid, even if it meant acting stupid. And Edna always told.
Yeah, now you're acting like a class clown just to get attention, but you want that attention because you want to be the cool kid. You want everybody to think you cool. You want to blend in with everybody, man. Who wouldn't? Especially when you think you're not cool.
We keep making that face and it gets stuck like that. Meanwhile, I'm just standing there holding my tongue, trying to talk like that. Till I suck my tongue on that frozen stop sign pole at 8 years old. I learned my lesson then because I wasn't trying to impress my friends no more. But I already told you my whole life story, not just based on my description. Because where you see it from where you're sitting is probably 110%
different.
I guess we would have to walk a mile in each other's shoes at least. What size you wear? I wear 10s. Let's see if you can fit your feet. My shoes just to see.
What it's
like to be me, I'll be you. Let's trade shoes just to see what it'd be like to feel your pain, you feel mine. Go inside each other's minds just to see what we find. Look at shit through each other's eyes. But don't let them say
you ain't beautiful. I took my bruises, I took my lumps. I fell down, I got right back up. After losing his best friend, Proof, aka aka Deshaun Halton, in 2006, admitted he fell down. Yeah, just with his mother, his ex-wife, and dealing with people who openly protest his right to rap. Until year 2004, after which he became to withdraw, he was regularly released multi-platinum albums. Helped his crew 102 with his career and kept getting back. You guys have to understand, Proof was his best friend, okay? Proof, for real, was his right-hand man. Proof, for real, I ain't gonna say Proof the one who really got Eminem into the rapping shit. Like, he got himself into the rapping shit. But Proof helped him. He helped him get them gigs. He helped him get them gigs in the hood. He helped him get them freestyles underground and all that. Of course, M could have did it himself, but Proof was his right-hand man. Proof had him connections. Proof was like, okay, you gonna see him as a white boy, but I see him as my nigga. I see him like, we gonna make it. I see him, he real deal. He gonna be the GOAT one day. Imagine your best friend dying. He dead and gone. Yes, that's gonna put you in depression mode, and that's gonna make you sad. Like, all the way down. Like I say, you guys, if you guys are dealing with depression and anxiety, which is in my life right now, you can overcome it. You can overcome it. And you can beat it. All you need to do is stay positive. Stay around positive people. Get away from the negativity. The negative friends. The bad friends that's giving you bad vibes. You know what I mean? Just stay in a positive place, man. Everybody's beautiful. Even if somebody think you ugly, we all have beautiful ways. Everybody's beautiful in their own way. Like, unless like you're just mean and miserable, then. I ain't gonna say you ugly, but you about there. But this was Eminem Beautiful. If nobody told you you're beautiful today, Eminem did. And I just did. Eminem Beautiful was very, very deep, very honest. You cannot judge people, especially if you don't know what they really been through. People tell you and show you what they want to tell you and show you. But at the end of the day, you don't know what they really go through. You don't know how they really feel. And I don't care how much money you got, that does not change your feelings. That does not mean you are not human. So, shout out to Eminem once again, man. This was beautiful. Let's get it.
Y'all jumped off at the porch late. I was already in a rental home. Early bird get the worm and it won't wait.